I've got another mega mailbag, and I might have been buying some things from my OS components, you think? Just a couple of things. Let's find out what we've got. There's some evidence here that I've just recorded another mailbag. Last week's one. Anyway, let's see what's in here. That. We're waiting for a whole bunch of parts to turn up for these fixing these Datron multimeters. So what do we have in here? MCT6. So that's five of them in there. And here's some more. Put up to Thailand. I don't know if we'll be able to see these through this wrapping. Probably not be well at all. I don't want to get them out until I'm actually ready to use them. Yeah, probably can't see them in there, can you? The last mailbag video, which I just recorded, I've got the 6N136. So I've now got all the Opto Couplers that I need. What's in this bag? I did buy different types. So these ones are NE5534APs, because the Datrons does have one of these, at least one of these that I've seen. So I thought I'd get some of those because I don't have any of those anyway, just in case they're a problem. Whilst I was getting some parts, they're fairly cheap. So a bunch of those too. So five of them. Yeah. Don't forget to subscribe and give us a thumbs up and that sort of stuff if you like these kinds of videos, or if you like electronics videos. What's in this one? 6N136 apparently. A bunch more of these. 815-1030. I think there's different ones I've got before. Yes, they are. So I've now got three different types of these particular opto couplers now, in case they've got different properties which might affect the Datrons. So I've got a differences there, because sometimes you need to match them to be equivalent to the original circuitry, otherwise you can cause all kinds of weird problems. So yeah, three different types, so I can try them all out. That's good. And my 14. Capacitors from the Netherlands. Some Vichys. This is a 16 volt 4700 microfarad. So I've purchased a bunch of these in different places trying to figure out which one's going to arrive first, because I was trying to get these Datrons up and running. You know, let's get the power supplies repaired, which is what I purchased them for. And I didn't have any spare stock. I had no stock of these value, I think. So I thought, well, I better get some, and now I've got a few coming. Which means at least next time I've got some. Oh look, it's some RS. It's some capacitors. So that's some element 14. This is some RS. Exactly the same parts. 4700 microfarad, 85 volt. Sorry, 16 volt. 85 degrees C. I think these are 85 degrees C as well. I think they will. Probably are. No, it's 105 degrees C. This is actually slightly better spec. So that's 85, that's 105. Make sure, watch out for that when I fit the things in. Now we have a mysterious package. Well, just RS and stuff. No idea what this is. Oh, it's a box inside a bag. That was helpful. I'm slightly curious. Right. USB plug. Battery. I remember now. Okay. This is for my lighting rig I've got here. Right now it runs off mains power, off a plug pack. But they've got the ability to have battery power instead. And I was kind of curious about it. I thought I'd give it a go, because I've got my lab number 2 set up, kind of. And rather than carting a light backwards or forwards, or using mains power, which can have cables dragging in the way sometimes, I thought I'd get some batteries. Yeah, okay. 3/4 4 apparently. So, power trust. Of course, power we trust. NP960. So 7,200 milliamp hours apparently. Pretty heavy battery actually. So two of those, both the same. Well, this is 970 Pro, that one says. Guess it's the fitment. It says 970 on here as well. Yeah, well, it's 970 Pro, so I'm guessing that's the larger one. Let's get this one out too, what the hell. There we go. Alright, let's see if it fits. Yeah, well, that one fits just fine, so the other one will fit too, because they're both the same, so that's good. And it even turned the light on and ran off one battery. You can use two batteries for twice the capacity, obviously, in parallel. So, excellent. That'll do the job. So here's the charger for it, rated at 10 watts. 1.2 amp input, 8.4 volt output, a half a watt times 2. Oh, sorry, half a watt, 5 watts times 2, so it's obviously 10 watts input, or 10 watts output. So, all that through this little USB cable. Always wonder about that. Anyway, so that's all fine, nothing too exciting there. And here's the little leaflet for it. There's some specs and info in case you care. You may want some of these yourself. That's in the Chinese version, yeah. Another package of my wrist, I wonder what's in here. Is it capacitors? Is it opto couplers? Any bets, anyone? Comments down below, tell me what you think. Come on. You got 5 seconds. Okay, maybe 10 seconds. Okay, I know what's in it. It's more opto couplers, MCT6s. Again, a different brand. How many's in here? On foam. It's like 4 on each one, is it? Must be 5. It's 10. Yeah, I suppose it's 10 in the bag, so obviously 5 on each piece of foam. So, yep, plenty of opto couplers now. No shortage of them. Thanks to my Patreon supporters that help me support me and help me to buy things from Mailbag and help me to buy this test gear and things like that. And anyone that sponsors my channel as well, which is, you know, such as PCB Wag, for example, or Siglent, who's loaned me gear from time to time to do reviews. All that sort of thing helps. PCB Wag helped me give me money. Siglent give me content, so yeah. And it's a Wi-Fi card. I don't actually need it now. Actually, this is the late 2011, I think, version Wi-Fi card. I've got a couple of these now, so I don't actually need it. Had a bit of a hiccup about which one I was going to use, and I ordered the wrong one initially. I actually ordered two of the wrong one, and this is the second one, which finally arrived a month after the first one. Thumbs up, do that first. Subscribe, click the bell icon to get notified about new videos when they come out. I'm doing a bunch of repair stuff recently. Doing these Datron 1062 multimeters, which is like the 1061, 1061A, 1071, very, very similar. Basically the same thing. I'm doing repairs on those right now. They're going to be a good video series on both of those units. And I've also got a Rackhold Dana 1992 to fix as well. That's just what I have on hand right now. I'm sure I've got other stuff around, which I've forgotten about. So make sure you subscribe and catch up those repair videos. Or if you've got any suggestions about things you want to see, chuck them down in the comments down below. And you know, I like to hear feedback from people, what you'd like to see me do videos on. I want to hear that too. You know, for a certain particular piece of test gear which is cheap and easy for me to get, I'll certainly consider doing it, especially for something I don't already have. I'm always open to ideas. Sometimes I just don't get things because I don't know they exist. So if you tell me about it, there's a chance I could get it, if I've got the money available. Of course, depends on my sponsorships and stuff. So thanks for watching, catch you later, and see you in the next video. Have a chat down below. Bye. I'll get my merch. Buy some merch. I've got some cool shirts too now. George, my cat's come in to rub herself on things. Go away. George, come on, out. Right, so I've got MCT6. The last mailbag video, which I just recorded, I've got the 6N136. What you would like me to see do, like you, I can't say,